Welcome to our lessons on partial differential equation. We continue our lesson on Fourier series by looking at the integral of odd, even, and odd and even functions, and we're also going to take a look at orthogonality relations. If f of x is an even function on an interval from negative L to L, then we are saying that the integral from negative L to L of f of x dx is the same as 2 times the integral from 0 to L, or 2 times the integral from negative L to 0 of the same function. So for example, if you consider the function f of x equals x squared plus cos, this is an even function because both functions are even. Then the integral from negative 2 to 2 is going to be, if you integrate x squared, you get x cubed over 3. If you integrate cos, you get sine x. So from negative 2 to 2. When you do the substitution in this, you're going to get 7.152. That will be the answer here. Now, if you pick the integral, 2 times the integral from 0 to 2 of the same function, you're going to get this. When you substitute, you get the same 7.152. And when you pick 3 times the integral from negative 2 to 0, you're going to get the same value. So that's why we are saying that the integral for negative L to L of f of x dx is actually 2 times the integral from 0 to L of the same function dx, and the same as 2 times the integral from negative L to 0 of the same f of x dx. We look at the integral of odd numbers. If f of x is odd on this same interval, then the integral from negative L to L is always 0. So far it's an odd function. And for example, f of x raised to the power 3 is an odd function. If you integrate that one from negative 2 to 2, you're going to get x to the power 4 over 4 from negative 2 to 2. When you put these two, you get 16 over 4 minus, you put these two, you get 16 over 4, and that will give you 0. So far as the function is an even odd function, when you integrate, you are going to get 0. So if you take this one too, it's an even function. So the integral of this will simply be the integral for x raised to the power 5 over 5 from negative 10 to 10. And that's going to give you 40,000 if you work it out. Now this is an odd function, so you get 0. So let's look at it from this and see. If you integrate sine x, you get cos x. And you are taking this one from negative pi to pi. If you put cos this, you are going to get cos pi minus cosine of negative pi. But you know that cosine is an even function, so cosine of negative pi is still as cosine cos pi. So you are going to have cos pi minus cos pi, which is going to give us 0. Now let's look at this integral. This is easier because this is an odd function. So the integral from negative 2 to this is 0. So we are only left with this. So the only thing we need to integrate, we can say this is the same as negative 2 to 2 cos 3x dx. And this is going to give us 1 over 3 sine 3x from negative 2 to 2. And when you compute that, you know you're going to get 1/3 sine 6 plus 1/3 sine 6. It's going to give us 2 over 3 sine 6. So that is the integral for that. Let's look at this integral for this function. I can eliminate a lot of things. This is odd, this is odd, this is odd. So the integral will be 0. So I only integrate this one and then this one. So I can write this one as equal to the integral from negative 3 to 3 of x squared dx plus the integral from negative 3 to 3, 1 dx. And the x squared will give you x cubed over 3 from negative 3 to 3 plus x from negative 3 to 3. That's when you integrate this one. So I believe you know where we are heading towards. So this is going to give us 27 3 raised to the power 3 over 3 reaches 3 raised to the power 2 minus, become negative, that should become plus 3 raised to the power 2 plus 3 plus 3. So 9 plus 9, 18, 18 plus 6. So this is 9 plus 9, 18 plus 6, that will give you 24. Now let's look at continue with some few functions. If f of x and g of x are continuous functions on a certain interval, then we are saying that if f of x is even and g of x is odd, their product is odd. I think it's obvious that if you have x raised to the power 2, which is even, times x raised to the power 3, which is odd, you are going to get x raised to the power 5. So that's the second one. Say that if f of x and g of x are both even, they are both even, then the product is an even. And if f of x and g of x are both odd, their products will remain even. We are going to need this in our derivation of the Fourier series. So this is some few try questions for you. You can try your hands on it. Now let's look at orthogonality relations. Let m and the n be positive integers. Now let's consider the following products of sines and cosine. Cos mx sin nx, cos mx cos nx, sin mx sin nx. So these are products. Now let's then take the integral of these products on an interval of length 2 pi. So we can say that with m and n being positive, we are looking for an interval from negative pi to pi, that is 2 pi. So for all n, we know that this integral is always 0. And then this one too is also 0. That's the integral from negative pi to pi of sine nx is 0. The integral from negative pi to pi of cos nx is also 0. We'll prove it very soon. So let's take this one. If you are to integrate sine nx, the answer is 1 over n cos nx. And this is the case we are integrating from negative pi to pi. So this is going to give you, if you put pi in it, 1 over n cos n pi. Then you put the negative pi in it, and minus 1 over n cos negative pi n. So, but cosine of a negative number is the same thing. So that makes this 1 over n cos pi n, or n pi, minus cos n pi, which is going to give us 0, which is going to give us 0. So that's why, in a similar manner, if I integrate this, I'm going to get 1 over n negative sine nx. So if you put this interval on it, from negative pi to pi, so if you put the top one, you're going to get negative 1 over n sine n pi minus, then you are going to put this one here, that will become minus, become plus, because it's negative already, 1 over n sine negative n pi. And we know that if you have negative n pi, any value for n, don't forget our n is equal to 1, 2, 3. Any value for n pi, you are going to get 0. Sine of n pi is equal to 0 for any n belong to the center of integers. So because of that, this and that will give us 0, and you are going to get 0. Now since product of cosine and sine m is odd, the integral over this period is 0, because it's an odd function. As this is 0, this is everything that you do, this, all these integrals will give you 0, because it is an odd function. Now for the product cos mx and cos nx, which is even, the integral from negative pi to pi is 0 if m is equal to n, and is pi if m is not equal to n. What they mean by this is that if we take this, m is 3, n is 4. So m is not equal to n. Therefore, the integral from negative pi to pi will be 0. I don't need to calculate it. If you pick this, because I have 7 here and I have 7 here, m and n are equal, so the answer is pi. Now, for similar, same mx, sin mx and sin nx is all even. Since the product of sin mx and sin nx is even, we can also say that the integral from negative pi to pi is 0 if m is not equal to n and pi if m is equal to n. And if you look at it, so this one, you give us 0 because this and this are not equal. And this one will give us pi because we have the same thing here. These are a few trial questions for you to try or something or your hands on. Thank you for watching.